There are 5 counties right now in the state of Florida that are under a state of emergency. That includes Miami-Dade, where I am, and Broward. Those are the 2 areas that were hit the hardest yesterday, and you're talking about roughly 4.5 million people that live in just those 2 counties. We are expecting sort of a similar sequence to play out, rinse, wash, and repeat from what we saw yesterday, where come early afternoon, that rain starts to reach South Florida. Yesterday, the expected totals were, you know, somewhere in the range of 10 to 12 inches. We saw 11 here in Aventura. Today, it's more like a few inches, but still, look behind me right now. I'm driving through a parking lot that's just canvassed in floodwater, and since the ground is already so saturated, a few inches or even a half an inch can make way more of a difference than it would have yesterday, which is to say it could trigger a flash flood emergency. Miami-Dade is under 1 right now still, and a flood watch all the way through Sunday. In terms of some of the scenes that we've seen playing out here, I watched as people were climbing outside of their car windows yesterday to push their vehicles through lagoons. We saw moms clutching kids trying to navigate their way through parking lots just to reach their cars, people bailing water out of their vehicles using buckets and shoes and whatever else they had at their disposal. Thankfully, so far, there have been no reports of any injuries. The county wants to keep it that way, but Miami-Dade's mayor did say she's expecting heavy rainfall later today. And warning, folks, do not try to drive through open water, standing water like what you're seeing right now. We're in a pickup truck at the moment. This is only a couple of inches, but it's going to rise. Nearly half of all deaths that occurred due to flooding happened because people try to drive through areas they can't just make it through. So please be cautious, and we'll be keeping a close eye on developments here in South Florida. In Aventura, Sam Brock, NBC News.